Welcome to driver training here at Duisburg Depot. Today you'll be learning to drive this BR101 locomotive in DB traffic red livery. This brief introduction will cover critical driving controls and passenger operations. Climb aboard to get started. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of the reverser determines the direction of travel. Set the exterior lights for the expected operation. It's time to get going. For this introduction, you'll be driving from here, Duisburg, to Essen Hauptbahnhof. After departing Duisburg Hauptbahnhof, you'll be taught how to activate the AFB control system. Release the brakes and apply a small amount of power to get moving. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Take a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked.
Schließvorgang eingeleitet.
Proceed to the next stop at Mullum Hauptbahnhof, unguided this time, and see how you get on. This locomotive is fitted with AFB, allowing the driver to set the speed of the train. It can also work in conjunction with LZB, when available, to automatically control and adjust the train speed based on the current and upcoming speed limits. To engage the AFB system, ensure the throttle is not in use. Activate AFB as indicated.
AFB.
Move the AFB lever to the indicated speed. You can now apply full power using the throttle, and the AFB system will... To change the train speed, simply adjust the position of the AFB lever. To disengage the AFB system, ensure the throttle is not in use. Then, simply deactivate AFB as indicated.
AFB.
The train is now under manual power control using just the throttle lever.
Türfreigabe. Türfreigabe. Türfreigabe.
Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.
Schließvorgang eingeleitet.
Welcome to this DBBR155 electric locomotive in DB traffic red livery. During this brief introduction, we will go through the startup and stopping procedures. Climb aboard to get started. To get the locomotive started, set the battery isolation switch. The auxiliary compressor will be used to raise the pantograph later. This locomotive draws power from the overhead electrical supply via. A lot of your time will be spent in the driver's seat. To get the locomotive up and running, set the reverser. Wait a moment and let the auxiliary compressor charge. Now, activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact. the locomotive. The compressor fills the air brake system with air so that the brakes can be released when you... The brake key confirms the train is in control from this cab. The driver... Headlights are important in letting others around know that a train is operational. To get moving, only a small amount of tractive force is needed. Once up to speed, this can be a... With the startup procedure complete, release the remaining brakes. To apply power, rotate the tap changer to the desired tap index. Now we're rolling, we can apply more power, and focus can be diverted towards achieving a desired speed. Now that the desired speed has been met, traction no longer needs to be applied, and we can coast. The tap index will need to be at zero before any braking force can be applied. Failure to do this will cause a traction lockout until the tap index reaches zero. There's a short distance between here and the next stop, so be sure to manage the train and prevent overspeeding. We are nearing our destination to Hohenlimburg Sidings and will soon need to start applying a small amount of brake force to perform a comfortable stop. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.
Welcome to this BR182 electric locomotive in DB traffic red livery. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the startup, stopping, and passenger door operations. Climb aboard to get started. The battery will power up the control desk and allow you to interact with it. This locomotive draws power from the overhead electrical supply via a contact arm. It's important to use the correct light configuration when the train is operational. A lot of your time will be spent in the driver's seat. To get the locomotive up and running, set the master switch. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. Headlights are important in letting others around know that a locomotive is operational. We now need to wait a moment and let the brake system charge. It'll take a minute or two. When stopped for longer periods of time, or when leaving the cab, a parking brake is engaged. We'll need to ensure that this is released in order to get moving. Use the master switch to determine the direction of travel. Give a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Boarding is now complete, so set the doors to... The train brake is used for normal line operations. Due to the size and weight of this train, small amounts... Now we're rolling, we can apply more power, and focus can be diverted towards achieving a desired speed. Coasting is a method used to easily move without engaging power, on a flat. There's a short distance between here and your next stop, so be sure to manage the train and prevent overspeeding. We're on final approach to Dessau and will soon need to start applying a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable stop. Like before, unlock the doors to allow passenger boarding to commence. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.
Thank you. Welcome to the BR-187 training module. We will get you acquainted with the BR-187 locomotive. You will be performing a short journey from Aachen Hauptbahnhof to Aachen. Start by walking towards the marked BR-187. This BR-187 is currently completely turned off. We will need to complete the sequence of button presses needed to turn the locomotive on. First, we need to turn the battery on. Next, we must activate the cab. Make sure the locomotive headlights are on correctly. We must now raise the pantograph. Make sure to close the circuit breaker. Finally, release the parking brake. We are now ready to depart. Apply some power to the engine so that we can begin our journey. Once we have reached 35 km per hour, remove this power so that we can coast through the station before applying it again afterwards. Thank you. This is the end of the journey and this training module.
Welcome to driver training here at Hagen Yard. Today you will be learning to drive this BR363 diesel locomotive in DB Railion livery. This brief introduction will cover train preparation, critical driving controls, and freight operations. Climb aboard to get started. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time. To activate the control desk, set the master key. To allow fuel to flow to the engines, To start the engines, set the engine start switch to the indicated position. To engage the hydraulic drive, the power switch must be activated. Press the changeover button to set this as the active. The reverser is used. Now release the parking brake. To release the train air brakes, set the driver's brake valve to the driving position. For this introduction, you will be performing shunting duties around Hagen Yard and forming a train. This train is now ready for operation. The throttle on the locomotive is a little... Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintain... Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of brake by moving the driver's brake valve into the braking range. The wagons are behind us, so change directions with the reverser and then contact the dispatcher to get permission to access the track they are in. The signal will change to white when we are clear to proceed. This yard is centrally controlled, so we don't need to manually operate any junctions. They'll be set for us.